it's James again. I just wanted to give you a little update on what's going on with the seeds here. This little greenhouse I got from Lowe's for like $40. It's worked great for me this far. So initially I had it over on the cement and I didn't have anything supporting it. We had some really bad winds that we get here off the hills, and this thing flew across the yard twice. If you remember, we talked about first starting my seeds and being unsuccessful. This was the greenhouse I initially used that I think baked. And so now I leave on nice warm days. I need this little hood piece unzipped and rolled up. But during the day when it's nice and warm, now like it's getting, we got up like 64 today. I put the seeds in here, the sprouts here, and little seedlings, and I put them in here and I roll this up. Even at 64, I know this is going to get up really high, and I don't want to kill my seedlings after I've gotten such a good start on them. I'm going to take a moment actually to show you some of the things, how well they're doing. Back here, if you look at this great root system here, not fully sure if you can see that there. Let's see, I'm not sure. This is my zucchini squash, and it's doing really good. I accidentally chopped off one of the edges there, but it's doing really, really good. And the leaves, I mean, the leaves are bigger than my thumbs, and I'm really happy with that one. I've got back here, I've got my Dixie squash. I'm hoping you're being able to see this since I'm in front of the camera, and the leaves are doing pretty good here comparing to my thumb, and got root systems coming out. This is doing great for me here. If you remember, I talked about, let's see here if I can find one. Yeah, here we go. And this was one of the tomato plants that there was multiples in the box, and I went ahead and I split them up, and this is doing just fine, just as good as all the other ones. It still needs to actually split and come apart there. And there's a couple of other ones I've done that way, and they've come out great for me. This greenhouse has four shelves, does really good. It's going to help hardy everything up for me, and because we have such strong winds back here, I'm really reluctant to leave them just sitting out, even on a good day, because the wind will beat them up really bad. So what I did is I supported these up with some of these stakes here. I used these stakes last year for tomatoes, and as you can tell, they're bent. These were on cherry tomato plants. The plants got so heavy that they actually bent over. So I, maybe for using as a teepee for like peas, I might use this again, but for anything else, I wouldn't use them anymore. They're just not worth it. I tried to put one in each corner and then post it up with a zip tie. I even used some bungee cords, and the bungee cords I wouldn't recommend. They tore it a little bit, so I had to put some duct tape on it. So instead, what I did is I haven't used my peat moss yet because I'm still waiting to build my boxes and everything. So I just took my three big bundles of peat moss and put it around the side. And as long as I don't have a wind coming from this direction blowing this way, I should be okay. And even then, you know, it's kind of holding pretty well, so we'll see. I may end up putting maybe a couple bags of manure or something like that over here, chicken manure or something, just to keep it from being pushed out of the way. Another thing I wanted to show you, here is the burpee system that I first used that I talked about with the little dome. This is the one that I actually put in this little greenhouse that I think cooked it, and I told you I had like a little fungus or moss that had started on it. I wanted to show you how hot this thing actually got in here, and I didn't realize it. It comes with a little weeping mat, and I'm probably going to use this again next year, but I'm going to use it for flowers because I don't like the idea that all 72 trays are together, because then I can't really rotate them in my light system that I have, my grow system. But I wanted to show you real carefully, not fully sure if you can see this. This is what the weeping mat goes on, and it actually melted inside the greenhouse. That's how hot it got in there. So if it's hot enough to melt this plastic, you know it's gonna kill your plants. A lot of people I've seen, they use this like inside in a south-facing window. Like I said before, I can't really do any germination or seedling growing inside my house because I have carpeting and I have really nice cherry wood floors, and I can't risk the chance of water getting on them and damage them. So the light system that I'm using and this little greenhouse outside is working great for me. So I'd highly recommend it. It's only $40. I know some people said they've gone to Walmart and other places, and they'll be on sale. I wasn't lucky enough. My goal is actually where we are right now to eventually put a small greenhouse here on this specific part of the property, but that's another 2-3 years down the line. But as you can see, my plants are doing really great. They're growing really well. Now I just have to wait about another month and we'll be able to actually come out here and be past our frost and start growing some plants in the sun. All right, good gardening. Bye.